Excitement with Soul, maximum excitement with Soul.
RB 400 in London. iPhone 11, Xiaomi Redmi K20 Pro, OnePlus 17, Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, Samsung Galaxy Fold. TV, 4X, METS, OLED, Android TV, Samsung, The Frame, QLED, 5.5, OnePlus TV.
Good evening, all of you. We have a gathering of very light professionals and intellectuals and industry people, media people. I wish I could name all of you because so many dear members of the jury are there, so many from the auto industry are there. So first of all, let me thank CNN for giving me this opportunity of being with all of you this evening. And I don't think there can be a better moment for me as Science and Technology Minister than being with you this evening. You just heard my dear colleague Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, and you must have got the idea of the vision of Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, our Union Surface Transport Minister also, and also an idea about what the government's vision is about. I always use such occasions to start, in fact, by paying my tributes to two leaders. One is, of course, my dear Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, who, as Prime Minister of this country, brought science to the center stage of Indian politics when he said, apart from Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, it also has to be Jai Vigyan. And most of the people know Atalji as a poet, a good human being, but I have watched him from very close quarters and have learned so many things from him. He always felt science was very close to him. The health was very close to him. Technology was also very close to him. Maybe the people from outside may not have felt that about him. But, and simultaneously, I would like to use this occasion to thank my Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, who we have felt in the last 6 years that he may not have studied science formally, but when he talks to us, when he talks to the scientists and the technologists, he has better ideas than any of the most qualified technologists or scientists or engineers. And he has taught us that the transformation has to be through technology. And technology and science has to be used for the benefit of the poor people to ensure that we are able to better the lives of the common man. And that is why the type of push that he has given to science and technology, the way he has created the innovation movement in this country, the way he, along with his total might of the government, from all sides, backs every young man with an idea in this country, and that's why there's a huge ecosystem of startups and stand-ups. The startup and the stand-up movement under him has become so robust now that we feel very confident that India's science, which has already grown into one of the best technological advancements in the recent years, is going to ensure that we are able to realize the dream of our Prime Minister to have Indian science amongst the top 2-3 nations of the whole world, to go up to that extent. And with backing of science, Prime Minister has, you see, the 175 gigawatts that he said at the initiation of his first term, now he has revised that. He says it has to be more than 400 gigawatts of clean energy. And when he says it's going to be electric vehicle only by 2030, as a science and technology minister, I can tell you with utmost confidence and certainty that we are going to achieve it. I'm going to give you a good news, because Nitin Gadkari ji was talking about the lithium ion batteries. And many of you may be aware, who keep in touch with the latest developments in the field, you must be aware about our CSIR. And CSIR is an organization which was born even before we got independence in this country. And today our CSIR laboratories have worked wonders and have produced technologies in virtually every field which help the common man in big ways. And one of our very prestigious laboratories in CSIR in Tamil Nadu, it has already done so much of research about the production of the lithium ion batteries and of course the sodium ion batteries, that very soon, in a couple of weeks from now, I am going to lay a foundation stone for the production of lithium ion batteries in India, in Chennai. And the government is going to spend almost 100 crores on the establishment of that factory there, which will be run by our, in fact, CSIR, with all the backing of technology. Most of our laboratories in CSIR have done so much for producing the clean energy vehicles, ensuring that we convert every waste into wealth. You must have heard about the aviation fuel which has been developed from Jetrofa. You must have recently heard about the plastics being converted into diesel, petrol, petrochemicals in our laboratory in Dehradun. And when I visited and inaugurated that plant in Dehradun recently, I saw our scientists, the auto industry, because you produce new vehicles, you may not like the idea. But when the Supreme Court said that after 10 years, you can't use the diesel vehicle. And our scientists there have, in fact, ensured that those diesel vehicles, they will now have a battery and induction motor, and they are going to train over 2,000 mechanics in this country for retrofitting of these vehicles after 10 years. So that's the level at which the scientists are in fact working, whether it's converting the used cooking oil, whether it is using the plastic waste in the roads and the highways that our Surface and Transport Minister was talking about. Virtually in every field, there is so much happening. The solar energy through the solar tree, through the solar lotus, through various applications of solar energy being used for the tractors. They have produced the tractor for the small farmers. And I think there cannot be a better application of solar, the clean energy, when we can see now the e-rickshaws, which actually is the real tribute to the poor man through the science and the technology. And with the help of the industry, I am sure that there are so many things that this industry will be able to deliver in the coming years. My only appeal at this moment would be that we have so many scientists with greatest of abilities right now. In the last 5 years as Science and Technology Minister, I have visited every science laboratory in this country. I have interacted with all types of scientists in this country. I have interacted with all scientists of all major developed countries of the whole world, whether it is America, whether it is England, whether it is Germany, France, Israel, South Korea. I can say with utmost confidence that our scientists and the achievement that they have brought about for us, it's not at all inferior to anybody in the whole world. We have the ability and the potential to deliver the best. And the CSIR about which I am talking to you, which gets us all types of technologies for every field, which help the common man better their lives, it is ranked at almost 15th position in a list of over 1,289 institutions all over the world, which are supported by government money, which are public institutions, where they do research, where they produce a technology, where they deliver it to the people of India through, of course, people like you, whether it is the auto industry or any other industry, and I know auto industry is a very, very important industry. You contribute so significantly through the manufacturing sector to the GDP of India. The country always remains indebted to you, and you have made the lives of people. So even if I didn't have a vehicle, I couldn't have come to you and attended your function. All the good brains in the field, they collect together, they join from one place to other only with the help of what you give us through the auto sector and through other technologies. So friends, I can assure you that on behalf of the scientists of this country, that if the scientists of the public institutions and you people, if you join together, if we join together in doing research and you give us the problems, I can tell you we can give you the solution. That's the ability of the scientists that I have seen. And together we have to ensure that we bring about a significant transformation through technology in the lives of the common people. That is what we ask our scientists also to do. We say, for you, what is important is your scientific social responsibility. You have seen the impact that has been made through the program which gave the millions of women that improved version of the gas chula. I know, as a health minister, as a doctor myself, as an ENT surgeon myself, how much of damage was caused to the young children less than 5 years with that smoke. And it is a scientific fact that if you can at least ensure that the child lives up to 5 years safely, then he can at least live further for 5-6 decades. That's research now, but we used to, so many young children and so many women, they used to lose their lives because of all this. This is all technology. Technology has huge potential, and for your auto sector also, I have seen the factories in America, a Tesla factory. I saw myself, we started this program with a robot, and I saw the impact of technology when the whole car is only, I think, produced with the help of a robot, right from starting A to Z. Everything is through the robots. And I can tell you that India has, right now, it is at a stage where whether it is artificial intelligence or robotics or Internet of Things, or it is through data analytics or whatever the applications of the advancements in science are, we are in a position where we can use them. We have started using them. We are using them in our health delivery systems also. We can use them for many other occasions. So this is a great, I think, movement. And I would like to congratulate CNN, IBN for flagging this issue, the power of technology, whether it's for the auto sector or for any other sector. You have flagged this issue to the people of India through this program, and I think you deserve absolute commendation, congratulations, and all my good wishes to the people who have who are representing the auto industry here. And I once again offer all the support of the Science and Technology Ministry, and wish you could also join us in our research endeavors to help our contribution in delivering the dreamt new India. Prime Minister has a dream for delivering a new India by 2022. And I'm sure each one of us, if we also have a small dream and if we blend our dream into his dream, I'm sure we can certainly bring back smile on everybody's face in this country. Thank you so much for inviting me to this function.